An evil incubus from hell plagues a woman in bed at nights. My neighbor left his wife because she got pregnant while he was away for almost a year on work contract. His wife, Mary, not her real name, told me she was not unfaithful. It was not my business and I did not want to get involved in the marital affairs of other people. Mary insisted she needed to talk with someone about her pregnancy. She invited me inside her place, which was a few blocks away where I lived. By this time Mary had already given birth. I asked what happened to the baby. Mary answered, there was no baby which came out. What Mary divulged shocked me. She said, it was a wind that came out. I said it must have been a paranormal birth. What I'm about to narrate is based on a real life episode. It was the first and only time I would be witness to such a bizarre phenomenon. Please click like as it helps to grow the channel. I'm a journalist from Cape Town, South Africa. I have left further video clips on the paranormal at the end of this video. I have also left my email below if you want to tell me your paranormal story you would like to share with the world. You can also read my paranormal books online free on the link below. I decided to report this story because I found the paranormal case of Mary is not an isolated one. Most people who have had similar encounters prefer not to talk about it. Mary told me people do not believe her, saying she was unfaithful to her husband. But she insisted she remained loyal in her marriage. Mary started telling me the whole story. Mary said, it started with me having very strange dreams about sex. The dreams became much more real, what I read up as lucid dreaming. I would dream a being would walk right through the wall and seduce me in my sleep. A person does not have control while dreaming, but I really liked the dreams. I afterwards shrugged it off as imagination and fairy tale dreams. Little did I know what was to ensue further. I have a teenage son and daughter and they later on told me, Mommy, we are scared because the house is haunted. I never saw any ghosts in the house nor have I ever seen ghosts in my life. My life was pretty normal at first, but things started to become very hectic. My daughter said, Mommy, my brother and I are scared to come into your room, because late at night we hear strange sounds coming from your room. Mary further said, I just laughed it off, because it could not be true that invisible beings or unseen things could exist. But how wrong I was. Soon my bed started vibrating. It was mild at first, but later on my bed started shaking. It always happened while I was asleep. My children said they were too scared to open my bedroom door to see what was really causing the noise. Mary continued telling me of her ghostly encounter. Her otherworldly experience left me in awe, because I did not know that ghosts could have sex with a human being. May was convincing enough, because she appeared petrified. Her entire face was smacked in a strange aura and her facial expression exhumed a strange joyful symmetry. Mary was about 28 years old at the time. That was more than 10 years ago. I have never seen her again, because she sold the house in order to make ends meet. She said further, it became much more severe when I started to wake up while dreaming of a being having sex with me. But while I woke up, I could feel an invisible entity taking complete control of my body. It always occurred between 2 and 4 in the early morning. The experience was real. I asked her whether the paranormal encounters were still occurring. She answered in the affirmative. Mary continued saying, it was so enjoyable that I could not wait to fall asleep. It did not happen every night, but most nights in the week. On the nights it did not take place, I would be very disappointed. I even cried a few times, because I became addicted to paranormal sex. I would undress at nights and wait for the invisible lover. It became very intense, because my bed started shaking violently. Then I started hearing the invisible being whispering in my ear. He always yelled my name over and over. The entity spoke with me in the voice of my husband. I now need help, because at first I thought it was a handsome male ghost. But it was not. I asked Mary if it was a deceased person she knew. She answered no, it was an unfamiliar being. I asked her to continue her story. She said further, the being tossed her around on the bed and in her room into different positions. I really liked it, Mary said. But one night I saw it. I asked, how did the ghost appear like? She answered. No. 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 It was not a ghost. It was not human. It was half animal. It was a demon. It was laughing and it showed me how well he was endowed. It looked eerie and very evil. I went to the priest who told me I am possessed. I do not believe I am possessed. The demon does not possess me, he merely uses me. Now I am so afraid to fall asleep.